Well, good morning. Happy Friday. Welcome to our daily devotional. And this week we're talking about fear, an emphasis on what it means to walk and understand fear. And so I thought it'd be great to introduce and bring someone alongside me for this conversation. This is my mother. She goes by the name of Ruth, very biblical name. And the reason that I think my mom is a great voice in this is back in 2015, she was diagnosed with a form of cancer called multiple myeloma, and just been walking through that for the last 5 years. And so moments of fear, and even now when we're in this time of this virus, we see just additional moments of fear. So she loves the Lord and is going to share a little bit of wisdom for us this morning. So take it away, Ma.
Thanks, Kirk. Obviously, we all grew up with fears and different types of fears. But one fear that I rarely had the entire time I was growing up and in my adulthood was a fear of illness. That was until, as Kirk said, back in 2015, when after fainting, I was taken to the hospital and then diagnosed with multiple myeloma. And this was like a strange disease to me. I'd never heard of it before. I had no idea what it was. And the fear was like, what's going on here? And yet, one of my greatest fears was, how do I tell my children? You know, how do I tell others? What do I do? And what came to my mind was a verse that I learned when I was a kid. And I learned it in the King James, which said, what time I am afraid, I will trust in you. In the more modern translations, it says, when I am afraid, I put my trust in you. And that when stood out to me. Because there are going to be times, and there are times when I'm afraid. And that was one of the times that I was afraid. And there have been many times since then that I've had to acknowledge what my fears are. The Psalm 56, Kirk's going to read the first four verses, are verses that just really have come alive to me, and just the whole psalm itself, because it really talks about what it means to acknowledge our fears.
Says this, be gracious to me, O God, for man tramples on me. All day long an attacker oppresses me. My enemies trample on me all day long, for many attack me proudly. When I am afraid, I put my trust in you, in God, whose word I praise, in God I trust. I shall not be afraid. What can flesh do to me?
I shall not be afraid. This was a psalm that's called an occasional psalm. It happened on a particular time, and if you read the part that's underneath the psalm there, it talks about when David was dealing with the Philistines in Gath, and he's also dealing with running away from King Saul. So it was a very difficult time in David's life. It's called the Lament Psalm because basically it cries out to the Lord for help. And usually it tells you what the particular occasion is or just why. And then it goes on to state what the crisis is. And then it goes on to just say, but I'm going to trust in you because of who you are. And that's one of the things that I've learned in these last almost 5 years, is that I can trust in the Lord. Sure, I need to acknowledge my fears, and I do. And there are times when I put them off. For example, if I'm supposed to take my temperature and I think it's going to be a fever, I'm like, oh, let's not take the temperature. Let's just be Pollyanna about this. But then when I realize that's my fear, that I have to acknowledge it, and the only way that it can be dealt with is if I acknowledge it. And so I've learned to acknowledge. When this coronavirus came around, it just intensified the possibility of me getting ill again. And I can remember that they gave out those, you know, those qualifications as to how you should stay inside forever. And mine, I fit both of them. I was elderly, even though I don't think I am. And elderly is 60 plus. And then the other one was my compromised immune system, which I have a very compromised immune system. And I also had the instruction from my oncologist to go nowhere, except when I had to come for, go for treatment for the John Thurer Cancer Center there in Hackensack. And so I've had times of fear. And yet each time when I've said, I'm going to trust in you, Lord, the fear is dealt with. And the trust is not in who I am or what my body is doing. It's that my trust is in him and that he knows what's best, that we can trust his heart. One of the songs as I was growing up that really meant a lot to me was a hymn called Give to the Wind Thy Fears. And it was written by Paul Gerhardt, who was a German pastor, and he lived during the 30-year war. And four of his five children were, he buried them because of disease, and he buried his wife also. So he went through a lot. But I just want to read the first two stanzas to you because it just really picks up on, I think, this particular psalm. And I encourage you to go read the rest of the words of the psalm. Give to the winds thy fears. And here it is. Give to the winds thy fears. Hope and be undismayed. God hears thy sighs and counts thy tears. The psalm goes on to say that God puts our tears in a bottle and saves them. God shall lift up thy head. Through waves and clouds and storms, he gently clears the way. Wait thou his time, so shall this night soon end in joyous day. So I encourage you to give to the wind thy fears and to know that there are those wind times, and that's when we learn to put our trust in him.
Awesome. Thanks for sharing. Hope you guys have a great day.